Oh, don't you just love it when Oda throws a giant plot dump at the end of the chapter, right? Don't you love it when he does that? And it wasn't even that, like, huge of a deal. I mean, it is a big deal, but it wasn't like a double-page spread, and Kaido's, you know, hanging out on his mighty throne in Onigashima, drinking a giant glug of sake, and the entire fire festival's going on around him, and he's like, glug, 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 and then he silences the entire room with a mighty grunt of, like, glug, glug. Everyone's like, Kaido must speak. What is he going to say? He's like, where is my son? And like, giant speech bubble, end of the chapter. It wasn't anything like that, that bombastic. It was just like, last page, one little panel, don't even get to see Kaido's full face. He's just drinking and he's like, ugh, look, where's my son? We don't know, sir. We'll go and find him. Okay, sir. And then that was it. Excuse me, Oda? Mr. Doe? You have a son, Mr. Doe? Like, come on, man. Like, you can't just throw that at this, okay? Oh, man, Oda's like, yeah, I'm just gonna throw that in there before the chapter ends just to, for people to get queued up to that little thing. You know, I'm gonna address that in this arc. Okay, man, it's crazy. And by the way, can we get Kaido's full name by now? Does he even have a full name? Maybe his name literally is just Kaido. And that actually does kind of make sense because in Japanese, the way that you would say king or emperor is Oh. So there you go, right? Okay, so, I actually made a video about this, I think back in 2018, because I thought it would be really cool if we found out that Katakuri, and by extension Oven and Daifuku, but mostly Katakuri, was in fact Big Mom and Kaido's child. Alright, I thought that would work just because of, like, how strong Katakuri was, the strongest child of the Big Mom family, and then, you know, you have the whole relationship with Big Mom and Kaido, which, okay, I think everybody sort of exaggerates that to the point where it's like, oh, they were totally a couple. We got a lot of really bomb fan art throughout that. This is my favorite one from ProfessorGemini. That was the same person that did that Blackbeard Attacks Totland, you know, fan chapter of One Piece, so really good artist. I love that right there, you know, younger Big Mom and Kaido hanging out there. We exaggerate it quite a bit. Like, oh, Big Mom's coming to Wano to get that child support back from Kaido, and Kaido's like, you know, lock down the country, make sure the whale doesn't breach the gates. You know, we can make jokes about that. And, oh, and then the scene when Big Mom arrives at Onigashima, and Kaido and Big Mom were arguing slash fighting slash maybe something else for a couple of chapters, and the whole mountain is shaking, and just boom, boom, and everyone, all the members of the Beast Pirates are like, oh, what are they doing up there? We're all gonna die! And then finally they come out of the freaking room, and they're just like, you know, arm in arm, like, oh, we're gonna be allies now in this war, you know? And I'm like, oh, okay, well, what were you guys doing up there? You don't wanna know. All right, yeah, you're right, we don't. So, a lot of jokes about that, but keep in mind, the only thing that we know for certain is they were both on the Rocks crew back in the day, and Kaido apparently owes a life debt to Big Mom somehow. That's what Big Mom called it. Like, that's a lifetime debt. That's the kind of thing, you know, because of the thing I did for you, this is the kind of thing I can call upon whenever. Like, a week after the debt was made, or 10 years after the debt was made, or freaking 50 years after the debt was made. It's a lifetime thing. I actually started to think about that. What if it was something like at God Valley when the Rocks crew was destroyed and disbanded? Rocks apparently died at that point. You know, Garp and Roger were attacking God Valley. What if Kaido was about to die back then? Like, it was like he was reaching his rope and then Big Mom did something to save him, and the whole reason why Kaido was able to escape God Valley was because of Big Mom. So they got away, Rocks himself was killed, the entire crew was devastated, except for, like, Whitebeard and Big Mom and Kaido and Shiki, and they all kind of spread to the Wangji! They all spread to the ocean and had the names for themselves, or they disappeared in the annals of history. But in the case with Kaido and Big Mom and Whitebeard, they all became Yonko. You know, maybe Kaido's only in that position because of Big Mom, so that's like the lifetime debt. But Kaido still doesn't want to deal with her. You know, he's like, I don't even want you to bring it up, right? But, you know, so there's no guarantee that the mother of Kaido's child is going to be Big Mom, but I have to say, if it isn't, doesn't that kind of raise, like, way more questions? Like, seriously, like, who else could have possibly been the mother? Like, a volcano? Did Kaido get really drunk one night and just fall into a volcano, except he didn't die and somehow he impregnated the volcano and then and then this magma slash dragon duck creature just emerged from the crevices of the earth and just I am the son of Kaido. That would also, I guess, make as much sense as anything, but right now, I mean, with Big Mom being at Wano and with the relationship that they had in the past, and you know Oda's, you know, keeping up to date with probably all of the jokes on the internet, I guess I'll throw my money into Big Mom being the mother, although I will say maybe Oda is also so aware of that, that he's gonna make it, like, super obvious, like, oh, it has to be Big Mom, but then at the last second he's gonna switch it around, like, oh, it's not actually Big Mom. You all think it's gonna be Big Mom, it's actually gonna be somebody else completely that we haven't even addressed in this story yet. You know, Volcano-chan! Alright, I'm just gonna go with Volcano-chan for right now. Okay, someone draw Volcano-chan, please. I don't know what she would look like, but it's the internet, you made Earth-chan, so go for it. Okay, so in the video, in the review, I talked about a theory that I read on the Reddit pretty much right after the spoilers were released, and I actually really enjoyed that theory, so I think I'm gonna stick with that as my main focus for right now. But the theory is that Kaido's son is dead. I think that fits just because we've never mentioned Kaido's son up until this point, outside of just, like, fan theories and stuff. You know, Kaido never brought him up, Big Mom never mentioned anything like it, none of the crew of the Beast Pirates ever mentioned anything, you know, Queen was never like, you know, where's Kaido's son at, you know? You know, I have talked about it before, and Roger mentioned it in his review, that, okay, you have the calamities that represent the face cards, Jack, Queen, King. Kaido is, like, the commander of everybody, so maybe he could be considered the ace of the crew. The Joker was, of course, Doflamingo. You know, suits of cards, you know, numbers are the numbers, you know, that all stuff makes sense. So whether or not Kaido is the ace, or maybe Kaido's son would have the rank of ace, but he died, so therefore the ace position is empty. You also have to figure, like, if we do go that route with it, we'll have two characters in this story named Ace. You know, Porcus D. Ace, Luffy's brother, and then just Ace, as in, like, just a member of the crew of the Beast Pirates. Just, like, King's name is just King, Queen's name is just Queen, right? Okay? So, that may be a little weird to have two characters named Ace. So, maybe, like, yeah, Kaido's son did die, and the Ace slot is just vacant because, you know, Kaido didn't want anybody to... No, that's my son's seat, and that's always gonna be my son's seat. That's the only person I want. Maybe it's, like, he's too broken up, right? That would also explain Kaido's alcoholism, something that I think a lot of people just figured is, like, that's just gonna be the character trait that Oda gave Kaido. Don't think too much into it. He's a heavy drinker. You know, Big Mom eats all the time, but that doesn't tie back into anything. Okay, yeah, that kind of did for the hunger pangs and the whole end of that arc. Okay, so everything Oda does, literally everything, is for a purpose. There's a reason Nami has red hair or orange hair. Red. There's a reason why Chopper has a pink hat, okay? Not just because I hear a look, but the color of the hat is significant. No, so you see, you gotta, like, ride that line in the center where it's like, okay, you're either gonna guess literally, you're gonna second guess everything that gets presented, or you're just gonna take some stuff at face value. With Kaido in the drinking, I just took that at face value. I'm like, all right, he drinks a lot. He's a big tough guy. He's a dragon duck, you know, whatever. But this could be an Oda thing where it's just like, no, I'm gonna give you a reason why Kaido drinks as much as he does, and I'm gonna make you feel sorry for him. You know, like, okay, well, you know, you're the writer. You take it away from there. And whenever Kaido gets really freaking just sloshed, he forgets that his son died, and he keeps asking for him. And this probably happens quite a bit because Kaido does drink quite often. So the rest of his crew just kind of go along with him. You know, just like, oh yeah, Kaido wants to know where his son is. Just say that they'll go and get him, and then, you know, by the time he'll eventually pass out or he'll get sobered up and he'll remember and he'll wake up and he'll know his son is no longer with us anymore. So that's the best you can really do in that situation. So that's the main theory I'm gonna go with, but there are some other ideas here on the table. So let's address the Katakuri thing. Once again, I made a video about this already, so I'm not gonna go too much into detail with that. One thing about that video that did always bother me that I do have a chance to bring up now, so why not? I believe in that video I brought up because Katakuri and his brothers, Oven and Daifuku, they were all born, they were triplets, they were all born at the same time, so the same father, and then of course Big Mom, they were the tallest members of the Big Mom, you know, family, you know, outside of Big Mom herself. Big Mom is 8.8 meters tall, Katakuri is 5.9 meters, Daifuku 4.8, and then Oven 4.9. Okay, so Daifuku is the shortest, then Oven, then Katakuri, then of course Big Mom at 8.8. So I said, because they're the tallest, therefore Big Mom had to, you know, get it on with somebody that was also pretty damn tall, and then that's why they're the tallest. So there's actually a bit of a correction to that, and that is in fact Charlotte High Fat. Charlotte High Fat is this really huge, disproportional dude where his legs are pretty tiny, but his upper body is just, like, jacked, you know? And he is even taller than Katakuri and Daifuku and everybody, okay? Probably not quite as tall as Big Mom, but getting pretty close to it. Like, if Big Mom is almost 9 meters tall, High Fat, by this perspective, behind Katakuri, he's probably close to 8 meters, you know, if not 8 meters exactly, maybe a little bit higher, or, you know, lower than that. So there's other members of the crew, at least that other guy that's, like, taller than them. It's like, well, you know, that still can make sense, you know, just because Big Mom, of how tall she is, depending on who her husband, who her husbando of the week was, depending on who that person was, might have just been a larger than, you know, larger human, you know, because you could have somebody that was a large human that doesn't necessarily have to be as strong as, like, Kaido or somebody. You know, look at Pound. Even Pound was a pretty tall dude, right? And then you got Lola and Chiffon from that marriage. So, yeah, and also Big Mom herself, the genetics for being as big as she is are in her, and she's one of the parents. So, yeah, that would explain that, but not really, like an ironclad sort of, like, reasoning why, you know, Katakuri and Oven and Daifuku might be Kaido's children, but, you know, I just want to bring that up there. They are some of the oldest kids. They're all in their late 40s, you know, they're all 48 years old, so that would kind of fit with the whole timeline and everything. Katakuri is easily the strongest child out of the entire crew, so, you know, Luffy had to fight him and everything. That would actually be kind of neat. You know, Katakuri fought against Luffy, Kaido's son. No, Kaido's son is not Luffy, Katakuri. You know what I mean? And then later on, after that, like, the arc immediately after, Luffy has to fight, you know, Kaido, his father. So there's something on the table. I don't know if anybody's really putting a lot more stock into that, or you're taking less away from it or anything like that at this point, but I thought that would be a pretty cool way, and you could definitely make it work. Oda could definitely, I think there's enough ways to connect it back to make that happen, but I don't know. There's a lot of people that were pointing out Jack. You know, just Jack is the son of Kaido, because Jack's got the horns. You know, King has his own horns, but they're not exactly, they might also be part of his costume, you know, his little gimp outfit that he wears. Queen doesn't have horns, but Jack has horns. It was also mentioned that Jack was a fishman, so maybe, though, it was actually, he's not a full fishman, he's a half fishman, and maybe Kaido, and we got it on with another, with a fishman, and then that's how, you know, Jack came to be. I'm personally under the belief that Jack is not Kaido's kid. I think he is just a full-blown fishman. I think there's another story involving Jack and how, you know, he came to be a member of the Beast Crew and everything like that. Also, I mean, I feel like Kaido's son should be a little bit stronger than Jack. I mean, Jack is really powerful. He's got a billion bounty. You know, he's the drought. He's mammoth. He's really strong. But I think it's very clear that Queen and King are stronger than he is. And also, Ashura Doji was able to slice him. You know, so I feel like Kaido's son, if it's going to be somebody, it shouldn't be Jack. Because Jack has not really, up until this point, he's been defeated a few times. And I feel like that kind of makes us feel like, oh, okay, it's just Jack, right? And then Queen, you think if Jack was really Kaido's son, you know, Queen and King would be chewing him out and dressing him down as much as they were. The relationship there seemed to be like, you know, Jack is like the dorky little brother, and Queen and King are constantly, like, shitting on him. You know, if Jack was really Kaido's son, would they really be doing that? I don't know if they would be, so I don't see that. I understand why you would go with that, because the horns and the teeth and everything. There was a guy that we got to see back during Punk Hazard. He was one of the members of the underworld that was observing the Shinokuni that Caesar did. And he was in that, like, that darked out room, you know, like, watching it on a monitor, you know, like, attempting to buy the device. And so, very clearly a member of Kaido's crew, because he had the horns and he talked about mentioning Jack. Like, I'm going to relay this information to Jack. So, clearly a member of Kaido's crew. Now, all of Kaido's members, like, that are pleasures and above, I don't think the waiters have horns on their head, but the pleasures have horns and the gifters have horns. But these are different kinds of horns than that. These horns look a lot more similar to Kaido's horns. So people were looking at this guy that appears in Punk Hazard in silhouette and thinking, well, what's up with this guy? Honestly, if it was a choice between this random person and Jack, I'm gonna go with the random person right here. We know literally nothing else about this person, just that he's wearing kind of like a sort of like Corazon sort of boa, you know, that little like feathered boa, or Doflamingo's boa, and then it's like all black. So actually, also similar to Law. There's a lot of characters in One Piece he's like to wear feathered boas now that I think about it. But and he's got the horns and he's bald. And he was talking to somebody, and after Caesar was defeated, he's like, I'm gonna go relay this information to Jack. And then that's all we got there. So, all right, it's on the table, so we'll throw it out there. There was a few jokes. I was looking through all the comments of the review, and I'm just thinking, I want to gauge the room here. Who do you think is Kaido's son? And I got a lot of people that were like, it's Zoro. I'm like, yeah, no, all right, let's just scrap that. It's Bartolomeo. I'm like, okay, that would be kind of funny, but no, all right, it's not Zoro, it's not Bartolomeo. Here's one that I originally figured, okay, this is just, there's no way. And I still think there's no way, I really don't think it's going to happen, but Momonosuke. Momo, not maybe like actually is Kaido's child. Maybe Momo might resemble Kaido's child, and so when he gets really, really drunk, he thinks that he is or something. Also to bring up, I don't know if this means anything anywhere, but Jack and Momo were born at the same time. Jack is 28 years old. Momo is 8, biologically, but chronologically, 28 years have passed since his birth, so they're the same age. Don't know if that connects back to anything. It was a connection. I thought I should mention it. So maybe Momo is not actually Kaido's son because, you know, Momo was born when Toki and Odin were aboard, you know, Whitebeard's ship. But it's possible that maybe he resembles Kaido's son, so he confuses him with him. And, you know, eventually there was like things like, oh, there's that thing, the Kozuki clan. I wanna see him again so I can ask them something, you know? So it might connect back to that in some weird way, all right? I'm not actually physically talking about, you know, Kaido got it on with Toki or something. But I'm just saying, like, it's possible it might be misconstrued as that, right? That might be the direction we're going with it. Also, yeah, Momo can turn into a dragon, but of course that's because of Vegapunk's artificial zone. It's not like he could... If Momonosuke could turn into a dragon as soon as he popped out of the womb, then all right, I was like, all right, what's going on here? You know, Odin looks at Momo and Toki like, that might raise some questions, but that's clearly not the case. But there are, you know, similarities to go on here. You know, Momo could turn into a Chinese dragon, Kaido turns into a Chinese dragon, you know, the Kozuki clan and Kaido, they have a connection back and forth, so... I figured I should mention it, although I don't really buy it. So, yeah, for right now, I'm gonna go with the theory that his son is dead. But there's still a story there. There's still a backstory that we need to see. Now, we just got done with, like, a 14-chapter Odin flashback, so I don't think Oda is really, you know, amped up, especially in the middle of this war, to, like, give us another flashback. So if we are gonna get a Kaido flashback, it's gonna be a while from now. In fact, Oda might even do the thing where it's, like, even after the battle is actually over, when Kaido is about to be defeated, like, you know, the final blow! Luffy! Boom! Kid! Boom! Zoro! Shing! La! Room! And, you know, everybody is just slamming, like, Drake is there, Hawkins is there, everybody's just slamming the ever-loving crap, Jinbei! Boom! And then finally, Kaido, his entire mountainous form begins to, like, timber! And then Kaido falls, and he starts to lose consciousness, and he's like, oh, is this how it actually ends? And then we get the flashback with Kaido. Maybe not like a 14-chapter backstory, but we get like a chapter or maybe like something like that. Just to give us a little bit more of elaboration. Because Oda brought up the whole sun thing. Like, if the sun is not alive, then there needs to be a flashback involving the sun. I mean, even if the sun still is alive, we still kind of... I want to know. I mean, I know you can't show it in great detail, Oda, but we need to know who the mom is, all right? Like, you can't just be like, yeah, Kaido, this guy had a kid. I want to know with who, and I want to know the circumstances. Was Kaido, like, you know, when the son was little, was really little, was he a good dad? Did he push him a little bit too far, and that's why he died? Or just like, you know, son... I could punch a mountain apart when I was 6 years old. How old are you now? 7, father. All right, it's your time. She just throws him at a mountain. It's, yeah! Well, looks like he wasn't ready. All right, son, get back over here. We'll try again. Son. Okay, that was really dark, but maybe Kaido, maybe not in the exact way, but maybe Kaido, like, pushed his son a little bit too far, had too high expectations for him, and then maybe something like that happened, resulting in his death, and now he got, you know, seriously, you know, addicted to booze because of it. All right, maybe. So, yeah. Anyway, let me know what you think about this below. Who do you think is Kaido's son? Who do you think's the mom? Does Kaido even have a son? Was he just really, really drunk? You know, live or dead? Let me know. Barry, I'm wondering, do you have a son, Barry?